Ben Doughty for Glenn McCrory's Voice of Boxing with Paulie Malignaggi. Paulie, I was pleasantly surprised to see you today because I wasn't actually aware until today that you've gotten involved with Team De Gale and Jim McDonald. How did this come about?
Yes, I'm good friends with James, and they kind of just decided they asked me to be a part of the team, and I don't have all the time in the world, but because James is my friend, I made an agreement to come in and out of the camp a little bit, and Jim is still in charge and he's at the helm, and obviously he's done a great job with James, because I see James very sharp in this fight.
What kind of role have you taken? An advisory kind of role?
Sort of a technical advisory role in the corner in the gym, with Jim McDonald being the head guy. I'll discuss tactics with Jim, or I'll discuss tactics with James, and we'll come together on certain things. Even on Fight Night in the corner, it'll be Jim talking, and me maybe giving a couple of reminders or whatnot, but me and Jim will be able to talk during the rounds because we'll be in the corner by ourselves while James is fighting.
Sure, I mean that's the way it's best to do it. If there's one voice in the corner, if there's two good boxing minds in the corner, you can discuss it while the action's going on.
Exactly.
Molly, I knew you. I know you don't remember me, but I knew you from back in the day when you were 12-0 when I first met you at Brooklyn in Gleason's gym in New York. And it was clear then you had a good boxing intellect and you were articulate, and you've distinguished yourself at the end of your career and since it's ended inside the ropes as a commentator. Do you have coaching aspirations to get more deeply into that?
I think a coach needs knowledge as well as dedication. I feel like I have the knowledge, but the dedication is a bit tough because I'm spread so thin with my schedule. But I guess you never say never.
Never say never, okay. With this fight, I mentioned it earlier, but the perception is that any decent version of James De Gale, even at 75%, beats Chris Eubank because he's technically too good for him.
Yeah, I feel the best version of James De Gale will be too much for Chris Eubank, no matter what version of Chris Eubank turns up. And that's kind of the goal, is to bring the best De Gale we can find. And I think in this training camp, he's the best De Gale that I've seen since I started working with him.
If you were, obviously I know you'd be pulling for your man, your team, De Gale, but if you were asked to make a more specific prediction about how the fight would break down, what would you tell me in closing?
It's hard because now I'm kind of biased, so it'd be hard. But I'm obviously going to pick my guy to win. I think he's got the pedigree and he's got the experience, and I think he's got a bit more tricks in the bag.
You think it's got 12 rounds written all over it?
You can't say for sure, but Eubank Jr. Is in the mold of his father in that he's very mentally tough. In that way, and
he's not in the same level as league as his father. Is that fair to say?
Well, I wouldn't say physically and on a talent level, no. But I'd say on the level of mental, I think Eubank Jr. is mentally very tough, just like Eubank Senior was mentally very tough.
Okay, well, Paulie, I'm very grateful for you making yourself available for the Voice of Boxing. It's fantastic to see you again, and I bid you and the team good luck on Saturday night.
Thank you.